Just 2 weeks, you'll have the Super Bowl. Next Friday, you'll have another Super Bowl of types. It's a battle of champions. Heavyweight champion Mike Tyson and former heavyweight champion of the world, Larry Holmes. It takes place in Atlantic City. Some people think that Larry Holmes, at the age of 38, is just too old. He's fooling himself. But according to Larry Holmes, he has been fighting the odds all of his life. For his story, let's go to Easton, Pennsylvania.
Everybody situated back in the back.
It is a rainy afternoon in Easton, Pennsylvania. The world's most famous tour guide, 38-year-old Larry Holmes, is showing us a section of America that he has carved out for himself.
I'm going to take y'all at my house in 1 second. Real quick.
It is a multi-million dollar complex that the former champion displays with pride.
Come in real quick and make a tour.
Larry Holmes, the proud businessman, is about to become a boxer again. For Larry Holmes is still not satisfied. June of 1978, Larry Holmes meets Ken Norton. Holmes is about to defy the experts. For Larry Holmes will take the title away from Norton and become the champion of the world. But despite his achievement, respect would not be knocking on his door.
Showing the people that say that Larry Holmes, you're not going to be anything, and I became something. And that what made me right there, so that I can live comfortably, set example, and let everybody know if they wanted to do something out of life, no matter what nobody say, that they can do it if they really put their mind to it.
September of 1979, he would knock out Ernie Shavers in 11. But first, Holmes would have to pick himself up off the canvas.
Good right hand. Larry Holmes doesn't know where he is right now.
In 1981, with the experts predicting he would be defeated, Larry Holmes would pound Leon Spinks into defeat. In April of 82, when he found himself the underdog, even though he was the champion, Larry Holmes would KO the great white hope, Jerry Cooney. In November of 1983, Larry Holmes would battle the son of a boxing legend, Marvis Frazier, the son of Smokin' Joe Frazier. Marvis Frazier was grossly overmatched. Holmes retained his title. In April of 1986, Larry Holmes would for a second time lose to Michael Spinks, despite his ferocious tactics. Michael Spinks would retain his heavyweight title. For Larry Holmes, he felt it was time to retire from the world of boxing.
Yeah, there's nothing left. There's no sense of me chasing ghosts. If I continue to fight, I'd be like chasing ghosts. I talk a lot, and I don't think I can get a fair shake anymore.
Calling all people, this is Larry Holmes. When I'm not in the ring, I'm singing my poem. Fighting hard from round to round, you just can't keep a good man down.
Now, at age 38, Larry Holmes is ready to go back into the ring against Mike Tyson, trying to recapture what he feels was stolen in Las Vegas.
What drives me far as this fight goes is the way I left the last fight, the way they done me. They done me in. They did a number on me. And I don't like the way they done a number on me. So therefore, I'm fighting so that the number will be reversed.
Heavyweight champion of the world, Muhammad Ali.
October of 1980, another 38-year-old former champion tries to reverse the numbers. But for Muhammad Ali, it was too late to recapture the past.
His mind was making a date that his body couldn't keep. His mind was saying, yeah, I can do it, but his body was not able to do it. So you cannot put me in that kind of category with Muhammad Ali, because it's a big difference between Muhammad Ali then at 38 than Larry Holmes now at 38 years old.
So now Larry Holmes attempts a comeback against Mike Tyson. This will be the greatest challenge of Holmes' career.
I'm going to fight this guy. I'm not going to run from him. He ain't got a cakewalk. If he think he got a cakewalk, he got another thing coming. Because I'm preparing for war, and that's it.
The 38-year-old former champion, seeking to regain the glory he feels was stolen. For him, it's war.
Larry Holmes and Mike Tyson.
Larry Holmes, the big fight, tries to regain the heavyweight championship now held by Mike Tyson. Spencer Christian's going to be taking a look at the challenger and the champ. We start with the challenger this morning, right?
All right, that is correct, Charlie. You know, most athletes at age 38 are looking towards either retirement or the broadcast booth. But Larry Holmes at age 38 wants to retake the heavyweight title, and he wants to take it from Mike Tyson, who is only 21 and the odds-on favorite. I visited with Holmes at his hometown training center in Easton, Pennsylvania, where the local fans get to watch Larry work out to the sounds of his own disco music.
It gives me a chance to beat the invincible. They say in Mike Tyson, the invincible. But I don't see where he's so invincible at. I don't see the guy learn anything. I know the guy can punch. I know he fights all kinds of ways. And as he said that I say he's a dirty fighter, he can't help it because he don't know how to fight. And I think I can prevent all that he's done to other people from happening to me.
I tell it like it is all the time because I'm going all the way.
Calling all people, this is Larry Holmes. When I'm not in the ring, I'm singing my poem.
This seems to be developing into a grudge fight between you and Mike Tyson. Is that for real or is that just a lot of hype?
No, it's not a grudge thing with me. It's something that we do. I'm not going out there to try to kill this man. I'm going out there to beat this man, to win. You know, he got a family, he got a life to live after this fight. A lot of this thing is like professional wrestling. It's a lot of hype, you know what I'm saying? But when you take it in the wrong context, then it's your own fault when you can't deal with it.
But there seems to be a lot of meanness going on between you two. I mean, Tyson wouldn't shake your hand at the press conference. You made the statement a few days ago that he's going to end up in jail 5 years from now.
I go by the little things that they cover up, like the California incident, they beat up a guy in the parking lot over some girl, and you cover it up. Champions don't do that. Champions don't beat up people. Champions don't hang out in all different sorts of kinds of places. Champions have images for people to look up to. They have little kids that say, I want to be like Mike Tyson. I want to be like Larry Holmes. I want to be like Muhammad Ali. They don't want to say, nobody wants their kids to say, I want to be like Leon Spinks, because he's what is known to be one of them bad guys.
I remember when a young Larry Holmes fought an aging Muhammad Ali, and many people think that the punishment Ali took in that fight is partly responsible for his condition today. You ever think about that and the fact that that might happen to Larry Holmes?
You cannot put me on the same plateau with Muhammad Ali because I didn't go through the rigmarole that he did. I've been a clean athlete all my life, not the drinking, not the smoking, not doing drugs, and not taking the abuse that Ali has taken. I have people that I have to look out for the rest of their life, my little kids, my family. I have them to set for. But if it comes down to Larry Holmes, it's gonna get all beat up and banged up and I can't do anything about Mike Tyson, I sit down on the stool and I won't move and get paid and go home.
Larry, I've known you for a long time and I know you've always been concerned about getting respect and you don't feel you've been given the respect that you're due. If you win this fight with Tyson, do you think you'll then get the respect you deserve and you will have earned your place in history?
I think so. I think a lot of people will respect me more, but you're always going to have a few out there in the spots to say, no way, you know, Larry Holmes, he don't deserve it. The world knows that I was gypped out of my fight with Michael Spinks, and the world knew that I was not ready to retire, and they forced it. And so now I retired. Now they came back and got me again. So now it gives me a chance to show the people that Larry Holmes is not as dumb or as finished as they think I might be.
There are no shortcuts, only one way. Forget about the past, today's the new day. What that you go to take round by round, you just can't keep a good man down.
The big fight will be on HBO tomorrow night, and tomorrow morning I'll have a look at the champion, Mike Tyson.
Interesting, though. He says if he finds he can't do it, he'll stay on the stool and take his $3 million.
If he knows he's hurt, he said he's not going to come out there and get hurt some more.
The way Ali did in that fight against him. Exactly. Very interesting. Thank you, Spencer.
Tyson versus Larry Holmes And James Brown of CBS Sports is here to tell us all about the matchup.
Well, all right, Kathleen, I think you use a proper word. Big is, in fact, the word for it. Two of the biggest names in boxing. Mike Tyson is the first undisputed heavyweight champion to come along in years, and he's never lost a fight. And as for former champion Larry Holmes, he may have lost some speed, but he's definitely as tough as they come, and Holmes is definitely motivated. He wants that title back. It's a big impact fight for everyone concerned.
I got to hurt Mike Tyson. I got to let him know what pain feels like.
Yeah, yeah.
I want Mike Tyson to be able to feel the impact.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I want Mike Tyson to know that Larry Holmes is not afraid of him.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I'm strong, and I'm going to overcome it. Combat. I'm a better fighter. I feel my will is invincible.
Mike Tyson isn't bragging when he calls himself invincible. He's all alone at the top of the boxing world, the only 21-year-old in the history of the sport to capture and hold on to all three championship titles. The Iron Man, whose fists have knocked out 28 challengers in 32 straight wins.
True. But he's holding my title, the title that they took away from me back in the day when I fought that guy by the name of Spink Stinks.
It was 1985. Holmes was alone at the top of the boxing world with a reputation like Tyson's. 48 wins, 34 of them knockouts. When the judges gave Spinks the decision, Holmes' pride took a beating. He retired. Tomorrow night, he could win it all back. It's hard to tell which means more to Larry Holmes, winning and stopping Tyson's 32 straight victories, or winning and finally getting the recognition as a heavyweight champion he feels he deserves. But win or lose, Holmes still pockets $3 million just for climbing into the ring. The promoters are keeping Tyson's share of the purse quiet, but it's no secret that a fight like this means money. Big money for everyone involved.
We found during the Spinks-Cooney fight this past June that we at Trump Plaza did in excess of $10 million more business than we would have done if it were not for a big attraction like that. We found that Atlantic City had their business enhanced by in excess of $30 million.
Home box office wants to be in the winner's corner, too. They're paying Tyson a record $27 million for exclusive television rights to his next seven fights.
Compared to him, everybody is a candle. He's a big beacon lamp right now in the sport. So when we look at it in those terms, not Mike Tyson the fighter, but Mike Tyson the entertainer, he's worthy of a major league contract.
To Nintendo, the home entertainment company, prize fighting is a game, a Mike Tyson punch-out game. They spent $10 million promoting it and made $35 million in sales. Far away from the hype, but well aware of what's at stake, both fighters are training hard to win.
I just need a peace of mind. I need to go out there and do what I gotta do, do the best I can with what I got.
He feels in his mind that he can beat me, and the promoters feel that he can beat me, and they put him in the position where he can challenge for the championship, and it's my obligation to defend my championship.
I think Larry's mind is telling him that he can beat Mike Tyson, his ego, his pride. I think his mind is telling him something that his body won't be able to translate into anything other than a painful defeat.
Larry has all the things the other fellas who fought Tyson did not use to their advantage, or they seemed spellbound, awed, or afraid to swap punches with Tyson. Larry is not that kind of a guy.
I think the world will be shocked because they're expecting a lot of jab. They're expecting a lot of footwork. You know, they don't expect me to get in there and brawl with them. I'm just as much man as he is. And there's no way I can lose this fight.
His past performance in the ring, you know, he's a magnificent champion. But I figure this is my era now.
One thing we do know for sure, Kathleen, Atlantic City won't lose from this fight. Nintendo won't lose and HBO won't lose. The only so-called loser will be one of the guys in the ring, and of course we'll find that out tomorrow night.
Quick pick, James.
I like Tyson. The odds right now are 9-1. I think those are too steep. And as Customato, the late trainer and legal guardian of Tyson, said, every great ex-fighter has one extra fight left in him, so be careful of this one. I think Tyson's well aware of that.
That's a very good point.
Oh, yeah?
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Thoughts on the fight, Holmes-Tyson?
Well, it's two black guys.
That's a joke, folks.
Okay.
The joke, you better not air that.
I don't know. Don King was on my show last week, and he swears that Larry Holmes is a multi-zillionaire. And Larry Holmes took very well care of his money. He's getting $3.5 million for this fight, and that he absolutely doesn't need the money. I mean, the taxes are going to take, this is petty cash.
Mm-hmm.
Holmes actually believes he can win. Told Don King he will win this fight. Boxing history will be made. Now, this could be Don King. I don't know what he's selling. It's on HBO.
You don't buy that.
I don't buy it either. The only thing I learned in watching sports all my life, I saw this once. If this gives you any hope to watch this. I saw a match once where Pancho Gonzalez, at age 46, played some young... Pancho won.
Yeah.
I mean, this guy was like 30-1 favorite. And Pancho did things like he'd fall behind 40 love, he'd blow the last two shots. Didn't chase him. And the announcer was going, look at us, it's reprehensible. Pancho's not hustling. And come back. When he get the lead, he'd move in. So the one thing you got to be worried about if you're a Tyson fan, he is 21 years old.
Yeah.
And this guy has been there.
Right.
Never completely discount champions.
Mike Tyson will defend his heavyweight title against former champion Larry Holmes at the weigh-in today. Tyson tipped the scales at 215 pounds, while Holmes weighed in at 225 pounds. Tyson is unbeaten in 32 fights with 28 knockouts, while Holmes takes a 48-2 record with 34 knockouts into his comeback bid.
I gotta let him know what pain feels like.
Yeah, yeah.
I want Mike Tyson to be able to feel the impact.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I want Mike Tyson to know that Larry Holmes is not afraid of him.
But I'm not gonna be like one of them guys that you hit with one shot and I'm falling down. You gotta beat me up, man. I'm gonna be on him like white on rice. I'm gonna be on him like skin.
All right, now, if Holmes can hurt Tyson in the first five rounds, I think he has a chance. But Mike Tyson will be...
So the generation gap takes the ring tomorrow night in Atlantic City. 21-year-old champ Mike Tyson weighing in today. Slim and trim, 215¾ pounds. Tyson, of course, defending against the old man, 38-year-old former champ Larry Holmes, who tipped the scales 10 pounds heavier, 225¾. Still a good weight for Holmes, who says he disapproves of the way Tyson conducts himself as champ. Tyson says the same thing about Holmes when Larry was champ.
Surprise, both Mike Tyson and Larry Holmes are each predicting wins in tomorrow night's World Heavyweight title bout. However, the odds tend to believe the current champ Tyson, as he is the overwhelming favorite for tomorrow's night. It was weigh-in time today, and it was also the first time the two have appeared together in recent months. You might remember Holmes boycotted the previous press conferences.
225¾. Larry Holmes, 225¾.
Larry Holmes, 225¾.
Mike Tyson, 215¾.
Okay. And there you see the tale of the tape. Tyson, who was the youngest champion in history at 21 years old in 32 fights, is undefeated. Holmes with two losses. He could become the oldest heavyweight champ if he beats Tyson. He is 38 years old and a grandfather at that. The former champ Holmes with a height and weight advantage, 6'3 compared to 5'11½", and Holmes about 10 pounds heavier than Tyson. And Holmes said today that he feels his 20-month layoff has been good for him.
Jersey Joe Walcott was 37 years old when he defeated Ezra Charles for the world heavyweight title in 1951. Muhammad Ali was 36 years old when he beat Leon Spinks for the WBC crown in 1978, as we just saw. Holmes is 38, the oldest ever to attempt to win the heavyweight title. Lou Tilly has more on this boxing grandfather seeking to fight back time as well as Tyson.
Most of his work is done at home on his computerized treadmills, but not all.
Larry Holmes climbs through the ropes and into the ring here at his own training center in Easton every day. But this is as close as we're going to get to him before the fight on January the 22nd. Larry Holmes has kept his training very much under wraps, and he says he has a good reason.
You be out there trying to look good for him as you look bad for him. Well, Larry didn't look good today. You write it. And then people say, well, Larry didn't look good today. Or Larry got a little bit fat around here, and Larry ain't this and that. Larry ain't that. And I don't need the headache, man.
Many interpret his attempt to put a leash on this bulldog named Tyson as lunacy. Larry Holmes has his own interpretation.
Fight. Could be a fight. Walk right out there and fight him. Might go one round, it might go 12 rounds. Might go 2 seconds. But I'm going to fight him. And Mike caught Tyson, can you take a punch? You'll find that out.
The conventional wisdom, to beat Tyson, you got to jab, you got to stick, and move. How do you intend to beat Mike Tyson on the 22nd?
I see a brawl. I see a brawl. I see him hitting me, and I see me hitting him back. But I'm not going to be like one of them guys that you hit with one shot, and I'm falling down. Got to beat me up, man, you know? And I'm timed. My face is bloody and bleeding. I bought $3 million of ice packs and put on my face.
And yet, Holmes has never been a brawler. A strong left hand? Well, ask Jerry Cooney. A powerful right? Ask Manolo Snipes. Ask Ken Norton. Ask Marvis Frazier. But a brawler? No. A ring tactician? Yes.
I think styles are everything. I think he's going to be poking with that left jab of his, and then Tyson comes in, he's going to lock him up. He's going to definitely lock him up and move him, spin him. He's not going to take that many shots from the guy. And Larry's not that easy to hit. I make it an interesting fight, a tough fight. Tip Tyson a little bit. I won't be amazed if Larry Holmes wins.
I'm going to use the jab on him, but not as often as I've been using the jab, because I'm going to fight him. You got to be off in, you know, long range. Whop, 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 whop. Right. To use the jab. I'm going to be on him like white on rice. I'm going to be on him like skin.
We'll see if Tyson can make Holmes not smile so much. Tyson has been listed as an 8-1 favorite to dispose of Holmes' comeback attempt. Win, lose, or embarrassment, Holmes is expected to make $2.8 million. Tyson is making between $4 and $5 million. So not a bad way to go if you got to lose either way.
I was going to say I'd go out there and just lay down for $3 million.
Fight is set for tomorrow night. Mike Tyson taking on challenger and former champion Larry Holmes. Mike Tyson weighed in this afternoon in Atlantic City at 215 pounds and 3/4 ounces. Larry Holmes tipped the scales at 225 and 3/4 ounces. Holmes is 16 years older than Tyson, and he says that this fight will be a brawl.
I see a brawl. I see him hitting me, and I see me hitting him back. But I'm not going to be like one of them guys that you hit with one shot, and I'm falling down. Got to beat me up, man. I'm going to be on him like white on rice. I'm going to be on him like skin.
Larry Holmes, I still say, if he can hurt Mike Tyson, I don't think Tyson has ever been hurt. If he can hurt him in the first 5 rounds, he might have a chance of winning that
fight. Oh, that's a nice thought.
Day for tomorrow night's title fight in Atlantic City. The 21-year-old champ tipping the scales at 215 and 3/4, looking as confident as ever. The challenger and former champ Holmes, 225 and 3/4. Larry says he'll do most of his talking in the ring.
Could be a fight. Walk right out there and fight him. Might go one round, it might go 12 rounds. Might go 2 seconds. But I'm going to fight him. And Mike caught Tyson, can he take a punch? You'll find that out. I see a brawl, I see him hitting me, and I see me hitting him back. But I'm not going to be like one of them guys that you hit with one shot and I'm falling down. Got to beat
Tyson. That's it. Holmes may have a point about Good. Tyson. He fights like a machine, with wrecking ball power, with a detached sense that this is a cold business and there's no room for hate or emotions in the ring.
Because when you have to deal with these emotions, FFM is always good that not have emotions when you work. Because once you get emotional, like fear, anger, happiness, you can no longer perform at the top level that you normally used to perform under.
Tyson is the ruling force in the fight game. Fame, fortune, and aura of sheer invincibility. And the strong suspicion is it's killing Holmes.
He intimidates people. I wouldn't say Mike Tyson does it. The media does it. And I'm not intimidated by the media because in the last 2 months, I had more press than he had in his whole boxing career.
So Holmes is driven by what he used to be, what he used to have. It's a motivation that's gotten other former champions in terrible trouble. Most recently when Holmes, then the young man, beat a 38-year-old Muhammad Ali, the same age Larry is today.
Holmes, though, is a guy who must continue to validate in his own mind that he's a success.
The old man going to teach the young man new tricks.
But could it happen? Could Holmes wrench back the clock? What would it take for him to beat Tyson?
There'd have to be a sniper in the crowd. And that's the only way.
As the 8-1 favorite, Mike Tyson is difficult to dispute. Nick Charles, CNN Sports.
Interesting. 8-1 favorite, but I personally think Larry Holmes has a chance, John. I'm telling you, if his jab is okay, the one advantage he's going to have over all the other guys that Tyson has taken out is that he's going to attack. The other guys wanted to survive.
Oh, no, wait a second. You got to get odds on the sniper. There's no way Holmes is going to win. Holmes time. It's going to be like fifth round. Holmes time is going to be out time. Tyson's going to... This is ridiculous. This is not Sugar Ray. This is not a comeback. He's 38. He's an old man. Tyson's going to take him apart.
Well, tell me how you really feel about it, John. I really want to know. And besides that, we're going to have Larry talk with you after the show.
In Atlantic City, Mike Tyson puts his world heavyweight crown on the line against former champion Larry Holmes. 38-year-old Holmes hasn't fought since he lost to Michael Spinks, 21.
Power. Now, you are playing with power.
Punch out by Nintendo. Power. 11 world-class contenders. Take them down with your controller, beat them all, and you've got a shot at Tyson's title.
Power.
But for that, you've got to beat Mike Tyson. Mike Tyson's Punch-Out from Nintendo. Now you're playing with power.
Tonight's heavyweight championship bout is a laugher in some people's minds and a legitimate matchup in other circles. Certainly, Larry Holmes is making a solid case where conditioning is concerned. Holmes has been in seclusion for the most part while scaling down to 225 3/4 pounds. His only losses came at the hands of Michael Spinks, whose style, more than anything, brought forth both defeats for Holmes. Tyson knows only one way to fight, so Holmes needn't have to worry about the tempo that will be brought forth. Mike Tyson's coming right at him.
Well, I don't plan anything different than for my last 32 fights because I've been so successful with the same tactics. And it would be ridiculous on my behalf to change.
People say that I'm broke, I need the money. If they want to say that, fine. You know, $3 million is not going to hurt me. You know, that's something that I can buy and build again. And second, it gives me a chance to turn it all around again.
Well, at this particular time, my championship's involved, and that's the most important thing to me in my life, because at this particular stage it's my security of becoming famous and, you know, restraining all the great amount of money that I've been making, and that means a great deal to me at this particular point in my life. So only thing in my mind is defending my title successfully.
They say in Mike Tyson they're invincible, but I don't see where he's so invincible at. I don't see the guy learn anything. I know the guy can punch. I know he fights all kinds of ways. And as he said that I say he's a dirty fighter, he can't help it because he don't know how to fight.
You can look forward to a victory by Mike Tyson.
Well, we'll find out.
Yeah, we will.
Get the victory. Let's go to Atlantic City now where the big fight takes place tonight.
Mike Forrest is standing by, not under the boardwalk, but near the boardwalk. Mike?
That's right. We're at Trump's Plaza in the Terrace Lounge overlooking the lobby here. And, you know, the odds right now are 8-1 against Larry Holmes. And quite frankly, I haven't found the one yet. Everybody here, all the fight people who have been wandering in and out of this hotel are saying it's Michael Tyson all the way. Larry Holmes doesn't really have a chance unless perhaps he gets him right in the first round, which nobody really expects, including former IBF world champion, heavyweight champion Michael Spinks, who I caught up to as he came into the hotel just moments ago. Does Larry have a shot at him?
Sure, Larry has a shot. I mean, Tyson isn't the greatest as they claim him to be. He's not... He may punch hard, but he's not all that great. He don't possess all. He don't possess, I guess, discoverable tactics to the point where he's just untouchable, like myself.
Why won't he fight you?
I don't know. I guess he's just outright ducking me. I don't know. Maybe he's scared. I don't know. You have to ask him.
Actually, there have been three fighters who've been in the ring with both Holmes and Tyson. I have one of them with me right now, James Bone Crusher Smith, who fought Larry Holmes back in 84 and Mike Tyson, I believe, in 87. You're one man who can give us an idea of what it's like to be in the ring with both these fighters. First of all, Bone Crusher, talk to me about Larry Holmes. Do you think he has a chance? And what kind of a fighter is he?
Well, when I fought Larry Holmes in 84, 4 years ago, he had a very good jab. He had the lateral movement. He was very difficult. I hurt him several times in the fight, and he was able to cut me, and I cut him, and the fight was stopped in the 12th round.
Okay, now Mike Tyson, a more recent occurrence for you, unfortunately again for you, not a victory, but talk to me about Tyson and how strong he is.
Well, I feel like I'm stronger than Mike Tyson, but what makes Mike Tyson so difficult is he's so short, and he fought me coming in low, and the hand speed. I don't think a lot of things have been said about his hand speed, but he is very quick. He put combinations together very good, and that's what I see of Mike Tyson.
Okay, the question of the night is, does Larry Holmes have a shot? He's 38 years old. He's coming in at 225¾ pounds, which is kind of heavy. He's 38. Mike Tyson's the young bull. He's a gladiator. Who's going to win this one, and in how many rounds?
Well, I think Larry Holmes has a chance early in the fight. He should try to win the first round, win each round, and just take control of the fight as soon as he can. And if he doesn't do that, I think as the fight wore on, I would favor Mike Tyson.
You know, I get that feeling from a lot of people here, if he has a chance, and no one will say he definitely does, but if, and that's a big word, they say it's early or not at all, and that's basically your opinion.
That's the way I see it. That's the way I see it.
Okay, Bone Crusher, thank you so much for being with us. You're going to have a front row seat for this one?
I'll be right there.
Okay. There were a couple of other major fight personalities here at Trump's Plaza who I caught up with as they arrived. We start off with Muhammad Ali and then Sugar Ray Leonard.
Champ, who do you like in this fight tonight?
I'm Pete Tyson.
Tyson?
Tyson knockout in round 7.
Does Holmes even have a prayer?
He has a prayer. Mike, I think that what's going to happen, or what needs to happen, is the fact that Larry Holmes just can't survive the first round. He has to gain respect the first round, because, see, what's going to happen, if he doesn't initiate or establish himself the first round to get some respect from Mike, he should look forward to the next round being the same, a replay.
Okay, back here at Trump's Plaza Casino Hotel. The fun thing about covering fights down here at the shore, Tim and Carrie, is very simple. A lady came out of the casino and said to me, do you have the time? And I said, yeah, it's 20 of the hour. And she said, what hour? That's what happens when you spend your time in casinos. I think, my prediction, Larry Holmes is not going to spend a lot of time here tonight. We'll talk to you at SportsCenter at 11:30 tonight. Back to Tim and Carrie.
Yeah, that may be what Larry's saying. What hour?
Exactly. They're having fun out there, obviously.
That's right.